Hello everyone, today we are going to do the second experiment, which is called as a helical spring. For helical spring, we are using two types of helical spring. The main aim of the experiment is to find what is a longitudinal vibration and in order to determine the experimental and theoretical frequency of the helical spring. So before we start with the experiment, we need to take what is the initial length of the helical spring with the help of the vernier caliper. Then we have to add the weight panel on it. Then we have to take what is the final reading of the helical spring. Then if initial length is L1 and final length will be L2, then the deflection will be L2 minus L1. So that will be indicated in the tabular column. Then this weight panel, it is around some 450 gram. For the first trial, what we are going to do is, we are going to add the weight of 950 grams to the helical spring. Now, for the first trial, we are going to add the weight of 950 grams, including the weight panel to the helical spring. So, I am just showing how to add the weight to the helical spring, including your weight panel. Now, tighten this, and for the first trial, what we have to do is, we have to make some deflection and we have to take the reading of for what is the time taken for the 10 oscillation. Now this will be the final length after adding the weight, including the weight panel, then we have to take what is the final length, that is L2. So L1 will be common for all the three trials and L2 will be varying depending upon the weight, how much we are going to add for the helical spring. And first trial, how we are going to conduct is, now I am going to just slowly pull this weight and I will be having a stopwatch in my hand. Now I am going to make a note, what is the time taken for the 10th oscillation? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now we got around some 3.56 seconds to make 10th oscillation. And now for the second trial, what we are going to do is, we are going to change the weight, that is, for the first trial it was 950 grams including your weight panel, and now we are going to make it as 1450 grams including your weight panel. Now what is the only difference is, the initial deflection, that is initial length of your helical spring will be same, but the final length varies depending upon the weight which you are going to add for the helical spring. Now we have to make a measure of what is the L2. Then for the second trial, how we are going to conduct. Now we are going to just make a 10 oscillation and take a reading, what is the time taken for the 10 oscillation in this way. Okay, stop. Now it has been taken around some 5 seconds to complete the 10 oscillation. Similarly, we are going to do the third trial. That means we are going to just add both the things. That means the first weight as well as the second weight, and we are going to make this as 1950 gram for the third trial. So we are going to add the weight for this. And as I told you, for the third trial, the initial length will be same for the helical spring. And as you add this weight, and which you are going to make it as 1950 grams, now you can see what is the variation in the length. So the length quietly extends, and now we have to take the what is the length of your helical spring. So this will be L2. So deflection will be always L2 minus L1. And now again we are going to take a reading, that what is the time taken for the 10 oscillation. So I'm just going to give a small deflection like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stop it. It has taken 5.48 seconds to complete the 10th oscillation. Now what we are going to do is, we have taken the three trials, that is for the first trial, the weight it was 950 gram. So we are using a second type of helical spring. And for the second trial, we added 1450 grams. For the helical spring, and for the third trial we have added 1950 grams for the helical spring, and initial length it was same, like it was 2.99 centimeter. We are going to take the length in terms of centimeter,
And as we add the weight, the final weight, as we add the weight, the length it was getting vary. That is, for the first trial it was 5.53 centimeter, for the second trial it was 6.87 centimeter, and for the third trial it was 8.54 centimeter. Now the deflection, as I told you, delta will be the final length minus initial length. So we got this length. And number of oscillation will be standard, and time taken to complete the oscillation, it depends upon the weight, how much you are going to add to the helical spring. Now how to find the theoretical frequency? That is, we have the formula called as 2 pi root of W by Ks into G. So where Ks is nothing but the weight of the pan and weight on the pan divided by deflection of the spring. So we have capital W by delta. So this capital W as well as this W, it will get cancelled, and deflection, it will be going to the upper side divided by gravity. So gravity is universal constant, that is 9.81. 2 pi is a standard, and we need to put the value of delta, that is which we got deflection, which is nothing but 2.54 centimeter for the first trial. Then we'll be getting the theoretical frequency for the first trial. What we got is 0.26 seconds. Similarly, we have to repeat for remaining two experiments or remaining two trials, and now we are going to find what is the value of Now we are going to find the experimental, no, this is called as a theoretical time, and this will be the experimental time. The experimental time, the formula is very simple. That is, what is the time for number of oscillation divided by number of oscillation, that is T. T, it is nothing but the, what is the time taken for 10 oscillation, and N is nothing but the 10, which will be standard. And for the experimental time, the first experiment, we got it as 0.28289 seconds. So similarly, you have to repeat for other two trials. Now how to find the theoretical frequency? That is, theoretical frequency, it is given by 1 by TH, that is theoretical time. And what the answer we got for the theoretical time, it was 2.63 seconds, that is 1 divided by 2.63. So we'll be getting 3.8 hertz. Similarly, you have to do the calculate the value for the experimental frequency. That is, for experimental frequency, the formula is given by 1 divided by theoretical experimental time. That is 1 divided by 0.289 for the first trial what we got, and we'll be getting the answer as 3.46 hertz. Now to calculate the experimental frequency, we have to use the same procedure for second and third trial. So this completes your experiment. The thing is, you have to, the very first thing is the weight attached, that you have to make a note of it, and what is the initial length. Initial length will be same for all the three trials. Final length, it is going to vary according to the weight. And deflection, the formula is given for the deflection is the final length minus initial length. Number of oscillation will be standard, that is 10. And what is the time taken? So this is a main tabular column, observation tabular column, that you need to make a note of it. And using this formula, we are going to find what is a theoretical and experimental frequency.